Hi, this is Charles Anderson. This is the third of my videos looking at how to use the basics of Aspen Custom Modeler. In this one, what I'm going to look at is how to change the degrees of freedom or change the specification of the problem, how to create some custom forms, and how to do a little bit of troubleshooting if things go wrong. So what I've got is a very simple model where I've got two streams that I'm mixing together. One is at 80C, all water. The other is at 25C. And is a 50-50 mix of glucose and water. So that gives me a nice mixture stream. So first off, let's create a custom table. What I want to do is gather together multiple variables at the, from the flowsheet level. So I'm going to create a new flowsheet level form that I'm going to call, mixer table. I'm going to make it a table rather than a plot. So if you make it a plot, obviously that lets you see how things are varying with time. A table is a list of variables. A history table is essentially the counterpart of a plot where you get the a table versus time. A profile plot lets you look at, for example, the temperatures in a distillation column trays. Profile table is the same thing. And then a custom control, you can use .NET to create your own tables and more complicated things if you want. Okay, so I've created a nice simple table. Make it slightly larger so I can see it. I'm just going to plop it down here. What I want to do is grab onto that table the flow rate of the two streams. So I click and let go and drag. That lets me put it on the table. So again, click, let go, click, and drag. And so that's the two flow rates are on the table. And then for this one, what I'd like to do is grab the temperature and the composition. So I'm going to click, let go, and drag. And then let's go with the glucose concentration. So I've got my little table with four variables. This is obviously a relatively simple table, but it's a nice way of sort of keeping together multiple variables and or key pieces of data that you want to work on together. Okay, so I've got a custom table. Now, what one of the nice things about Aspen Custom Modeler is that you're solving the equations directly, so you can change the structure of the model on the fly. As long as you keep it mathematically feasible, you can change the structure of the model on the fly. So, for example, what I could do is I could say, rather than fixing the flow rate of the warm stream 1, I'm going to free that, so you see it goes from being bold to being non-bolded, and I'm going to set the temperature. And let's make this temperature, let's make it 60C. So I've changed the value, I've changed the specification. You'll notice that when they're both free, my degrees of freedom is one degree of freedom underspecified. So I need to fix one more thing. And when I change this to fix, it goes back to my green square and says that I'm well specified. So now, how much of the hot stream do I need to get the system to hit 60C? I hit run, and you can see it's about 1400 kilos an hour to get it to hit 60C. Let's say I not only do I want it to be 60C, I'll leave that for now. Okay, so that's how I can change the specification, how I can change things around. One of the things that you'll see is as I've made those changes, if I double click on the triangle here, it tells me how the problem is set up. It tells me it's legal and I've correctly specified it. It also tells me which variables I have changed from their default specification. So you can see it's telling me that stream S3 and S1, I've freed and fixed those. So that also corresponds to the fact that they're black here rather than blue. That the color black indicates that they're not at their default anymore. So that's how I've got that set up. Now, I could be tempted to say, okay, I now want to work out how much of stream 2 do I need to get a glucose composition of something else. So I could free that up and fix the glucose concentration to 25%. And that looks like it's a feasible problem. If I look at it, it does say it's going to solve. The problem is, though, that I've freed both the flows, so there's nothing telling me what the overall flow rate should be. So I'll run, and it's come back and tells me it can't find a solution just because it's not a very well posed problem. So instead, what I'm going to have to do is reset that one to default, reset this one to default, make sure it still runs, and then I can manually fiddle with this. Well, the problem is, of course, I can't independently set the temperature and the composition. If I put more of stream 2 in to try and raise the concentration of glucose, the temperature at 60 is fixed, and so it'll just put more of S1 in. So I'm going to have to come up with a different way of formulating the problem if I want to specify both the temperature and the composition of the stream with just two mixed streams. It's not really a feasible problem. Okay, I think that's what I wanted to show for this simple demo, so I shall stop there.